Oh, the things I do because I love you guys. Do you ever just think, don't worry about it? Like, there has to be an end to the madness of the left. The level of virtue signaling, grandstanding, and hypocrisy, double standards, it's all got to end at some point, right? And then you look at the lineup for Best Pictures at the Oscars and see that Call Me By Your Name is listed for Best Picture. And then you realize, we have not hit that floor yet. I'm Ben Davies, this is Pure Hollywood. Call Me By Your Name is the touching love story of two men and their consensual sexual relationship as the young boy who is 17 starts to explore his sexuality with 31-year-old actor Armie Hammer, who maybe plays 26 in this story. I have to admit, after Kevin Spacey was ousted from his lordship in Hollywood, I thought maybe this was going to be a bit of an awakening here. You know, like maybe the seduction of minors might be frowned upon in this community. I mean, after all, there are currently thousands of people in jail right now for very similar scenarios to this movie, and particularly in wake of the fact that the LAPD opened a case this fall about child sex pedophilia rings in Hollywood. Not to mention Hollywood's recent It's Time and Me Too campaigns that I thought would push against such relationships. Particularly maybe the glorification of an advance or a sexual relationship between someone of power in a position of influence and a susceptible individual that's underneath them. That's what I thought, but are you kidding? This is the Oscars and hypocrisy knows no bounds. But hey, maybe this movie wasn't just nominated for the Oscar because of its political, leftist, progressive brownie points that it slammed into a 2-hour movie. As a movie, I give this a 1 out of 5. This is the worst movie of the year without question. I really did try to hold on to my disdain for Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri as the worst movie in the Oscar lineup, but halfway through this movie, I would have watched that on repeat than to finish this one out. First off, the dialogue is so on the nose. You could literally close your eyes, listen to this as an audio tape, and not miss a beat, know exactly what is going on. Literally, it's two men telling themselves what they're feeling. But hey, this must be a beautiful romance, right? No, there is absolutely zero romance and no obstacles to overcome for this 2-hour love fest of a movie. It's literally the 17-year-old kid trancing around his father's house, and then you have Oliver just going around doing business work, and these two men staring at each other and just talking about sexuality. And meanwhile, a little 17 Elio is having a sexual relationship with this young girl twice in the movie, and in between these two scenes, he's sniffing the shorts of this 30-year-old man that he's starting to fall in love with, and then has sex with a peach. I'm not kidding. This is insane. And through all this, there's like weird, awkward sexual stuff that happens throughout the movie. You think maybe there's going to be something interesting to come, but no, it just abruptly stops at 2 hours when he gets a call from his lover. It's like, hey, dude, by the way, I'm engaged. Deuces. But maybe this movie is really artistic. Maybe there was some great, groundbreaking stuff they did with the camera, you know, unique storytelling or a way to tell it. Well, my critic review is a 1 out of 5. I'm not joking. Like, I literally scored Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri higher in all these categories. The transitions of this film are so jumpy and convoluted. Like, it looks like a high schooler's highlight football reel they slammed together on iMovie. It literally feels like more jump cuts than one of my videos when I'm trying to find the centerpieces of this 5-minute ramble that I do about all these movies. And the music itself does the same thing. It's this weird melodramatic music, and it'll just stop midway through a scene for no reason. Like, you think the audio kicked out on your TV or something. You're like, what? And there's no artistic influence for it. There's no reason to do this. Not to mention, one of the biggest rules of any script writing thing is you don't tell the audience. You don't say, hey, I feel this way. How do you feel? Well, I feel this way. You don't tell the audience what is going on. In this movie, they literally sing it to you. There are songs about Elio being like, oh, I love this guy. I don't know what to do. And Elio's heart is broken. Like, we know, we're watching it. What are you doing? You could start this movie at any point and get the exact same experience. You're not gonna miss anything in this movie. My faith and values is a 1 out of 5. Shocking. Okay, look, here's the thing about it. I did look up the age of consent in Italy. The age of consent in Italy is actually still 14, which I think is absolutely insane. So in that aspect, it's not like technically illegal to them necessarily gross or pedophilic, whatever. But this is nominated at the Oscars. This isn't the Italian movie awards. This is the Oscars in America, in Hollywood. And there have been so many gross scandals popping up in the Hollywood community. I get it. There have been other movies like this one. American Beauty, for example, got some heat, but it is not like this movie. In American Beauty, there is an older man played by Kevin Spacey, who at the time, I'm not sure if he was living as a gay man or not, but in this movie, he starts to fantasize about his daughter's friend, this beautiful blonde, but nothing actually happens. At the time, they did get some criticism for putting this in the movie, but the relationship never comes to fruition. In this movie, they glorify it for like 2 hours of this 17-year-old boy and this older man just sleeping together. And I could just, as art, give it a pass if it was a decent movie. But this is the worst movie I've seen maybe all year. I was talking to one of my good friends in Hollywood after I saw it, who's a great actor, a great coach, great critic of different movies, who also happens to be gay. And he was like, dude, I hate that movie. And I was the target demographic. Not only is this film just a dumpster fire, but in wake of all the sex scandals, the police investigations, the new documentaries like Open Secret talking about the pedophilia rings in Hollywood that you can watch for free, the PG-13 version on Vimeo right now. But it also seems like the Hollywood higher-ups are placing their flag in the sand saying, this is okay. And if you don't like it, don't expect to get an Oscar. I'm Ben Davies, this is Pure Hollywood. And another fantastic news, you can now download the Rebel app and take me with you wherever you go to get exclusive content in the entire Rebel lineup.